Hello, this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! Just wanted to show you that I did indeed get all the bestiary entries from the boss fight from yesterday, and I've made it back to the ninth floor, or the ninth basement level, of the Tower of Babil. So, let's go put Legay's key to use. Kinda odd that he would be the only one to have a key, but, well, there we go. Well, that's what the orcs said. Well, you'll see. Oh, goblins. I always knew the Horde didn't like the dwarves. But anyway, let's use the dancing dagger to take out this guy. Why not? Let Rydia get in on some of the action. There we go. Easy enough. You figured they'd put more powerful guards to... I don't know. Guard the cannon. And the bad guys seem to have no hesitation to blow themselves up when they don't get their way. What's going on, Yang? What are you gonna do? You gonna use the selfie method on these? Yeah, pretty much. Yang! You forgot to strip yourself of all your equipment so we could take it with us! No, actually, I did remove all of his equipment. So. You know, they use that explosion animation quite a lot in the game, but I like it. Big explosion. Now, if you're playing the Super Nintendo version of the game, if you hold up against the door here, you can actually get in the room before the game says, no, you can't get in the room anymore. It takes a little while for the game to figure out that it has to lock the door, but they screwed that up. And you can get permanently locked in there, so don't do that. But I showed that in the original LP, so. Well, nothing else we can do here now, so I'll meet you back on the first floor then. Okay, we're back on, well, not the first floor, but... Well, you know what I mean. Uh-oh. Blue light. Wait a minute. There's blue light. Then there was the green light. Purple light? Code purple! Code purple! Yeah, pretty much. Nuts. He's back! What's the worst he could possibly do? I like how they do the bridge collapsing in this version of the game. Nice touch. Deus Ex Machina! Woohoo! Fortunately, my cape acted as a parachute this time around. Yeah, I kind of landed a little slowly there, but... Well, there we go. Yeah, the girl our former king sent us to kill. And her village. Uh-oh. Why aren't they firing at us? Couldn't they just, I don't know, shoot us down like they did last time? Maybe Sid made some upgrades. Nuts. Well, if Golbez already knew how to upgrade the airships, then why didn't he do that before? I don't know. We got cannons of our own. Let's put them to use. You can do it! How did we get all the way up there? What are they, just chasing us in circles? Okay, let's get to the overworld. What do you mean? What engine? Oh, well, yeah, this is an airship. I was gonna say, what engine? This is a ship! But I was like, oh, yeah. Sounds like a plan. Just throw it over the edge, then. Sorry, not gonna happen. What do you mean? You don't need to sacrifice yourself like everyone else. Uncle Sid. She's not, or he's not literally her uncle, like biologically. I guess that's affectionately. Attention passengers, we may be experiencing turbulence and then maybe explode. You bring the grenades this time? That wasn't much of an explosion. You might be okay. Well, no, probably not now. Nuts. Well, we've explored everywhere we can. What do we do now? Well, this is a Final Fantasy game. What did you expect? Heck, the villains choose death so quickly, too. But anyway, we gotta head back to Baron, so let's go do that with kick-ass music! Yeah! People sacrificing themselves for the cause? Not even shedding a tear over it. But anyway, did Sid say that? Well, I forget whether he said it or not. He's supposed to. We gotta go talk to his engineers. I guess I kinda glossed over that line. Nah, whatever. I don't think it matters who you talk to, but we gotta get a hook for our airship. What do we need that for? Shouldn't we already have an anchor on this thing? Of course, I don't know why you would need an anchor for an airship. Wouldn't you just, I don't know, land it? I mean, what is it gonna do? Float away like a balloon? No, that's my side LP. I like these cute little scenes where they're fixing up the airship and everything like that. No dialogue or anything, just jumping up and down. Not quite as cute as Ott jumping up and down, but you take what you can get. Sounds like a plan. Oh, okay, so we gotta get back in the Tower of Babil, but in the overworld this time around. Well, it kind of blew it all up. How ironic, we're babysitting Sid. Or, we were babysitting Sid. But we only have 4 party members. What do we do now? Well, first things first, I want to sell some excess equipment, and I'll be right back. Okay, we're all set and ready to go. First things first, before moving onward, I want to store some of my excess equipment so I actually have some room for the treasure we're going to find. Just so you know, here's my setup. I'm not even going to list it in the video description because I don't want to have spoilers there. Obviously, I'd have to say that Yang wasn't around anymore. But anyway, I do want to store some stuff for later. Maybe I'll use it, maybe I won't, but you never know. But anyway, I do want to store the claws for later because there are other people besides Yang who can use them. Let's see, store the killer bow for later. Green beret, black belky, you never know, you might be able to use them. And then as for excess equipment you want to hold on to, obviously the ice equipment. The reason why I have the fire equipment is because in the next area, people will need them. There's enemies who are weak to fire! Game? Okay, so anyway, let's go grab the hovercraft. Where did I leave that the last time? Well, I think the last time we had it was way back at Mount Hobbs. You remember that? About a month ago, or whenever you watched that episode? But you don't tell me you watched this whole LP up to this point in one sitting. But anyway, we gotta get over to Eblon. I think it's like northeast of Fabul, or southwest of Baron. Okay, so now we can bring it over here. Go across these shoals. There's another place where we can use that, but, well, I'll go over that when it becomes pertinent. Right now, not so much. This is about when you're intended to go to Eblon Castle. Now, there are some rather unique enemies that you can only meet up with in the Eblon area. I could have done it before, but they would have been rather difficult for me to kill at the time. Okay, Kane, so I almost said Yang, but no, Kane, take out the one that we didn't kill quite. Now, the thing with these guys are just like the ones that we met up with in the ancient waterway or old waterway, whatever they're called. If you don't kill them in one hit, they'll revive or they'll retreat or something rather like that. So you want to take them out quickly as you can. Okay, there's two other new enemies around here, and they're in the same battle. So hopefully I'll be able to find them quickly enough. There we go. Now this battle I might have been able to do with Yang. That would have been nice. His kick can take out those fledgling rooks rather quickly too. So switch rows. Switch! And let's get a bio going just to take out those rooks there. Roo. I think the KH is silent, if I'm not mistaken. I speak English good. Alright, got him. Ooh, learned two new spells. Nice. Finally learned Kuraga. That's a really nice healing spell. Let's get into our hovercraft. Yay. And then we'll head on through the cave to Eblon. What awaits us inside? How do we get back into the Tower of Babil? Can this game get any edgier? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! This is HG Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!